सदाशिवसमारम्भां शङ्कराचार्यमध्यमाम् अस्मदाचार्यपर्यन्तां वन्दे गुरुपरम्पराम्। ॐ सहनावतु सहनौ भुनक्तु सह वीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै। ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः। सुखं नित्यं स्वप्रकाशं व्यापकं नामरूपयोः अधिष्ठानं बुद्ध्यबोध्यं बुद्धिर्दृग्यत्वनिर्मलम् अपारं सर्ववेदान्तभेद्यं प्रत्यक्परं महः तदेवाहं नमत्तोऽन्यदिति मे निश्चिता मतिः। After answering the first question regarding the Jiva Brahma Aikyam very elaborately, now the next question is answered. The question is Aham Brahma Iti Gnanam Kasya Bhavati, to whom this knowledge takes place. It may look like a very academic exercise, it may look like, but the people who are interested in understanding the things completely, for them this becomes very important thing. If any prakriya, any siddhanta does not give answer related to this siddhanta, then that siddhanta will not be acceptable. So you cannot say that why do you bother about it, whomsoever the knowledge happens. That is not the answer satisfactory to everybody. Because I want to know, if I don't get the answer, then the whole prakriya given doesn't set well in my mind. Any prakriya you give should give me the answer of all my questions. Something may be wrong perception, wrong understanding. I am ready to understand that. But you have to explain to me how it is wrong perception, how it is wrong understanding. I want answer. You cannot simply say that whomsoever it happens. You want knowledge, no? So knowledge will come. To whomsoever it has to come, it will come. Why do you bother? That will not satisfy. Sometimes the teacher does not know the answer, so he will give such answer also. Why do you bother? So it will not satisfy. Therefore, this acharya is giving the answer. And when student is asking the question, to whom this knowledge takes place, he has got the basis for raising the doubt. It is not mere curiosity. He has got some technical basis to ask this question. If we follow your prakriya, the questioner's mind is this. If we follow your prakriya, that Jiva is consisting of Chidabhasa and Kutastha Chaitanyam, Ishvara is consisting of the Chidabhasa and the Brahma Chaitanyam, and therefore, based on Kutastha Chaitanyam and Brahma Chaitanyam, there is Abheda. Based on Chidabhasa in Antakarana or Avidya and the Chidabhasa in Maya, there is a difference. But based on the Kutastha Chaitanyam and Brahma Chaitanyam, no difference. That prakriya will set well when I get the answer to this question, that this Brahmagdhanam happens to Chidabhasa or Brahmagdhanam happens to Kutastha Chaitanya. If you cannot give me the answer, then your whole understanding for your whole prakriya explained by you will not set in my mind. In science also, any theory proposed should answer all the questions. In that realm, in that premises, it should answer the questions. If it doesn't answer, that theory will not be accepted. So similarly, this Siddhanta, that Jiva is consisting of these two, Chidabhasa and Kutastha, Ishvara is of Chidabhasa and Brahma Chaitanyam, based on that oneness, is all this will go well when you answer my question. That to whom this knowledge happens. And this questioner's mind is, either way we have problem. If you say the knowledge happens to Kutastha, then Kutastha will not be Kutastha. Because knowledge is happening, takes place, jayate. Jnanam kasyapi jayate. Jayate is a vikara. And upayan apayan dharmaha vikaroti hi dharminam. Means any vikara coming and going will make the locus vikari. And therefore if jnanam is born in kutastha chaitanyam will be vikari. If it is vikari, it cannot be called kutastha chaitanya. That was one. Other option is chidabhasa or chidabhasa vishishta buddhi. That also is not possible because chidabhasa or buddhi is not Brahman. They are mithya. How can you say it is Brahman? Even if it says I am Brahman or it has got the knowledge, it is a Brahma rupa jnana. Like a servant of the king is claiming I am the king. Is a Brahma rupa jnana. So Chidabhasa is claiming I am Brahma or Buddhi is claiming I am Brahma. It is a bhranti matra. Like some people have got some psychological issue. They get the feeling I am the president speaking. In US it happened. But professor while giving the classes, he got some psychic issue. He started talking like president. I am the president speaking and all. So initially students took it as like making fun and all. But afterwards he kept talking about that. Then it was found that he has some psychic issue. So this Chidabhasa telling or Buddhi telling I am Brahman, how can it be accepted? It is Brahmagdhanam. And Brahmagdhanam cannot remove this samsara. That was the question. And if you say that dhanam, let it be Brahma, then it will not be useful because it will not remove samsara. That was told in the second paragraph. Then answer is given. Answer is what? Aham Brahma iti jnanam abhasasya eva. I am Brahman, this jnanam is of abhasa. To Chidabhasa it happens. But Chidabhasa is telling I am Brahma based on its identity with Kutastha. So, Jnanasya Adharaha Chidabhasaha. Kintu Jnane Aham Shabdasya Arthaha Kutastha. Like, if question is that who made this alu parota, then answer is given that I made alu parota. Now, which aspect of you is telling? Tongue only is telling. Did tongue make alu parota? Tongue did not make. Tongue can eat it. Oh, to sapad raha hai. Khayega, kuch karega nahi. So how you never ask that how tongue can tell this I made it? You don't ask this question. Similarly, this Chidabhasa is saying this. Is a locus for this jnanam. But what is meant by the word aham in that jnanam is Kutastha. That is going to be the answer. But this knowledge happens in Chidabhasa. In fact, any happening is always in अनात्मा। Either you call it बुद्धि विशिष्ट चिदाभास और चिदाभास विशिष्ट बुद्धि। And here it is said this बुद्धि विशिष्ट चिदाभासे एव अहम् ब्रह्म इति ज्ञानम्। And the चिदाभास not only ज्ञानम्, the Guruji wants to answer very comprehensively. He says not only ज्ञानम्, even अज्ञानम् also there only. So you don't ask me after next question. Okay, jnanam is to chidabhasa. What about ajnanam? Chidabhasa. And who will get jnana phalam? Chidabhasa. Alright, so that is how the answer is going to be there. And so, aham brahma iti jnanam abhasasya eva and not chidabhasa. All seven states belong to, are there in chidabhasa. And in that seven states, jnanam also is included. So your answer is included in that. Aham brahma iti jnanam kasya bhavati chidabhasasya bhavati. Not only jnanam, before jnanam whatever happens, after jnanam whatever happens, all happenings are in chidabhasa. That is going to be the topic. And then the seven states are being described based on panchadashi seven chapter shlokas. And yesterday I said in the panchadashi ajnanam avrutihi tat, it is not there, tadvat it is there. Ajnanam avrutih tadvat vikshepasya parokshadihi. So not tat, tadvat, otherwise anvaya will not hit that. Tats vikshepa tadvat, similarly ajnana avruti and similarly vikshepa parokshadihi, all of them are chidabhasas. All right, so these seven steps were seven avastha, seven states belong to chidabhasa. What are they? Ajnanam, ignorance, avaranam, concealment or veiling, bhrantihi, bhranti means delusion, vikshepaha, projection, parokshagnanam, indirect knowledge, aparokshagnanam, direct knowledge, shokanashaha, the removal of grief, atiharshaha, abounding joy, happiness, means niratishayananda prapti. These seven steps, seven states belong to chidabhasa. Alright. In that ajnana avaranayoho swarupa, we were saying, he somya aham brahma na jane iti vyavahare karanam ajnanam. For the transaction, mental or verbal transaction, अहम ब्रह्म न जाने, आई डू नॉट नो ब्रह्म, फॉर सच मेंटल और ओरल ट्रांजेक्शन कारणम द कॉज इज अज्ञानम, इज इग्नोरेंस. एंड आवरणम इज व्हाट? ब्रह्म नास्ति, ब्रह्मन इज नॉट देयर, ब्रह्म न भाति, ब्रह्मन इज नॉट एविडेंट. इति व्यवहारस्य व्यवहार कारणम तु आवरणम. द कॉज फॉर द व्यवहार दैट ब्रह्मन इज नॉट देयर एंड ब्रह्मन डज नॉट शाइन, ब्रह्मन इज नॉट एविडेंट फॉर सच मेंटल और ओरल ट्रांजेक्शन, द कॉज इज आवरणम, वेलिंग. हियर दिस वेलिंग एंड दिस अज्ञानम मे लुक अलाइक, बिकॉज इन दैट अज्ञानम आल्सो व्हाट से अहम ब्रह्म न जाने, देयर आल्सो यू से ब्रह्म नास्ति न भाति, ब्रह्मन इज नॉट दैट, ब्रह्मन इज नॉट एक्सपीरियंस. सो दे लुक अलाइक बट देयर इज अ डिफरेंस. दिस अज्ञान इज फोकस्ड ऑन द पर्सन, आई डू नॉट नो, एज इफ आई हैव गॉट ए कवर. सो इट इज रेफरिंग टू, इट इज सेटर्ड ऑन द पर्सन. I do not know Brahman. Whereas Brahma nasti na bhati, they are referring to the veiling of Brahma. Brahma na bhati, Brahma nasti. So it is focused on Brahma. So Brahma nasti na bhati iti vyavaharasya karanam avaranam, veiling. As if the cause for this type of transaction, that Brahman is not there, Brahman is not experienced. For such transaction, the cause is called avaran, veiling. Indicating what? That Brahman is veiled, therefore this type of vyavahara is there. Alright. And Panchadashikara made little extra. That after wrong inquiry, when person says, Brahmanasti na bhati, then the cause for that is called avarana. Alright. Anyway, we can take in general also, we can take in the manner it is given in Panchadashi. Alright. So, up to this we had seen. Avaranena vividaha vyavaharaha bhavati. Because of avarana, veiling, concealment, vividaha, twofold, vyavaharaha, transaction, expression, bhavati takes place. And why twofold vyavahara is possible by avarana, single avarana? Yataha, because agnanasya shakti dvayam vartate. Because agnanam, which is veiling Brahma, has got twofold power. Yataha, since shakti dvayam, twofold power vartate is there, agnanasya of agnanam. So there is twofold power of agnanam. Therefore, by avarana, due to avarana, there is twofold vyavahara. And he himself explains, what are the twofold power? Tatra, eka, shaktihi asatva padika, anya abhana padika. Tatra, of these two, nirdharane saptami, of these two, eka, one, is, one shakti, one power, is asatva padika. Asatvam apadayati. Vyavaharatah asatvam apadayati iti asatva padika. That which is cause for the vyavahara, the transaction, expression of non-existence of Brahma, that is called asatva padika. So that power of avaranam, which is responsible for the vyavahara, that Brahma nasti, that power is called asatva padika. It will be explained further, but just for our understanding here. So one power is asatva padika. Apadika means attributing, bringing about asatva, non-existence of what? Non-existence of anything, but in this context Brahma. Shaktihi, power. Anya, anya shaktihi, another power is abhana padika. The cause for non-cognition, non-experience is called abhana padika. Apadika means that which brings about the cause. Ubhayoho api shaktyoho. For both the powers, avaranam iti eva sadharanam nama. There is common name in the form of avarana itself. Means asatva padika shaktihi, abhana padika shaktihi. Both of them are called avarana shaktihi. Is it clear? Both of them avarana shaktihi. Alright. This is one prakriya. Generally, we don't go in this much detail. We only say avarana and vikshepa, kaam chala lete. But when we have more to tell, when Vichar Sagara is discussed, Panchadashi is discussed, very leisurely. So, Pujya Swami used to say, Panchadashi has that advantage. It without any hurry, leisurely it answers all the questions. So, that is the beauty of Panchadashi. There was one Swamiji in Rishikesh. He was called Panchadashi Swamiji. Why? Because he used to teach Panchadashi only, mainly. And he brought out this Hindi translation and all. So very good word to word translation, very nice. But what is Shiva? Shiva Temple Swamiji. So that Swamiji, he was a Mandaleshwara of Kailash Ashram for some time, retired. And retired, he did not complete. And that Panchadashi Swamiji. Swatantra Anandji. All right. So, very good. So, in Panchadashi, this very leisurely it is talking about. Okay. So, what is the topic said here? That Avaranam has got twofold power or two aspects. One is responsible for Brahma Nasti Vyavahara. Other is responsible for Brahma Nabhati Vyavahara. So, Asatva Padika and Abhana Padika. But both of them are called Avaranam. Now he himself accepts. Vastu nasi iti pratiti hetu bhuta shakti hi asatva padika iti. Vastu na bhati iti pratiti hetu bhuta shakti hi abhana padika iti cha uchyate. Just now we saw that. Vastu nasti, a thing is not there. Iti, in this manner, pratiti hetu bhuta. The cause for the shakti, the power, which is in the form of the cause for pratiti, experience. What type of experience or expression? Vastuhu nasti. A thing is not there. Like a vessel is covering some sweet or some fruit. Then what? That will be the cause for the vyavahara. What? Vastu nasti. When this person, diabetic person comes, sweet should not be seen. So covered with a cloth or something. So then what? Oh, nahi hai, dekho kaha hai. So nowhere sweet is there. Vastu nasti. Jalebi is not there. Vastu nasti. Iti pratiti hetu bhuta shakti. We are talking in a gross level. Here is a power. So the power which is the cause for the pratiti, the expression, the mental or this oral expression, that Vastu nasti. Pratiti generally means experience. The experience in the form of thing is not there, which is expressed by the words. So that pratiti, that thing is not there. For that, whatever is the cause, that power is called asatva padika. The cause for the non-existence. Really, it is not cause for non-existence. It is the cause for the vyavahara of non-existence. Non-existence experience causing power. Non-existence experience causing power. Okay. Or existence negating experience causing cause. The cause for the experience of the negation of existence. Existence is not there. So asatva padika. Vastu na bhati. A thing does not appear, is not evident. Iti pratiti hetu bhuta. The cause for the pratiti, the experience, that a thing does not appear. That shakti, that power, the power which is the cause for the experience that a thing does not appear, that power is called abhanapadika. Iti cha uchyate. Is called abhanapadika. Apadika means the cause. Abhana means the non-experience. So the power which is the cause for the vyavahara of non-experience is called Abhana Padika. Here Ekadesha Anvaya is there. Iti Pratiti. Okay. No, we need not say Ekadesha. Vastu na bhati iti pratiti hetu bhuta. Iti then pratiti. Iti has got anvaya. In a way it is Ekadesha. Iti pratite hetu bhuta. Iti is not going with the last bhuta. Iti pratite hetu bhuta. In that way Ekadesha anvaya. We can say Ekadesha anvaya. Okay. Itham, in this manner, Brahma nasti iti vyavahara karanam Agdanasya asatva padika shakti hi eva. In this manner, Brahma nasti iti vyavahara karanam. The cause for the transaction that Brahman is not there, that cause is Agdanasya shakti hi eva. It is the power of Agdanam only. And that power is called asatva padika shakti hi. It is the shakti which is responsible for the experience of non-existence of Brahma. So, Vyavahara Karanam Kim? अज्ञानस्य असत्वापादिका शक्ति. सो दिस शक्ति इज दिस पावर ऑफ अज्ञानम ओनली. बट व्हेन दिस शक्ति इज लुक्ड अपॉन एज द पावर ऑफ द ट्रांजेक्शन ऑफ नॉन एग्जिस्टेंस ऑफ ब्रह्म, इट इज कॉल्ड असत्वापादिका. ब्रह्म न भाति इति व्यवहार कारणम अज्ञानस्य अभानापादिका शक्ति एव. The cause for the transaction that Brahman is not evident is the power which is responsible for the abhanam, non-cognition of Brahman, and that power belongs to ajnanam. So the cause for the transaction that Brahman is not evident is the power of ajnanam alone, and that ajnanam is called asatva padika. And here the different word is used, avarana, to distinguish the one is from the standpoint of the individual and these two are from the standpoint of what is covered, and in this example Brahma. See, earlier also is aham na brahma, brahma aham na jane. So brahma aham na jane and brahma na bhati look similar, no? So what we are, how we are distinguishing brahma aham na jane is from the standpoint of individual, as if the buddhi of the individual is covered. And here brahma na asti, brahma na bhati, these two experiences are referring to the brahman. It is revealing brahma being not there, brahma being not experienced. So focus is on brahma. So it is a brahma centered explanation of same ajnana. So when ajnanam is referred to from the standpoint of the individual's incapacity, then we are calling it ajnanam. And when we are referring to that experience of Brahma being not there or Brahma being not evident from the standpoint of Brahma, we are calling the same ajnanam as avaranam. That much is different. Generally this distinction is not made. In this case, it is made. Alright. So, Brahma Drishtya Ajnanam Avaranam Iti Uchyate. Jiva Drishtya Ajnanam Ajnanam Iva Uchyate. Okay. And when Brahma Drishtya it comes, then twofold powers are imagined or are considered. One is abhanapadika, asatvapadika. Why this division is made? Because when jnanam comes, two different things are going to happen. So first you will say Brahman is. So what type of job it does? It removes avaranam. Oh, avaranam is gone? Not fully, not gone. Some aspect of avarana only goes. What is that aspect? This aspect. Asatva padika shakti of avarana goes away by paroksha jnanam. And abhana padika goes away by this aparoksha jnanam. That is going to be told, therefore we have done it here.
Both.
But here we are referring in the context of the individual about the total. So avarana shakti, here we are talking in the context of brahma jnanam and brahma ajnanam, mainly brahma ajnanam. So more focus is on the avaranam as a factor responsible for the experience that Brahman is not there, Brahman is not evident. So we are talking mainly in the context of individual's experience, because the question is asked for the individual. Okay. But it has got the what is called corresponding total is there. Okay, so up to now we have talked about two factors. One is ignorance, other is veiling or concealment. concealment is of two things, the existence of Brahma and the shining of Brahman. The status of being evident. Okay. Now, next one is, third one is Bhranti Swarupam, otherwise called Vikshepaha. Ajnanam, number one, Avastha. Ajnanam belongs to whom? Chidabhasa. Avaranam belongs to whom? Chidabhasa. Chidabhasa means, Chidabhasa is alone, is having this Avarana, which is covering Brahma. Chidabhasa is having Avarana covering Brahma. Okay. Then, now third, Bhranti Swarupam is the explanation of the third stage, Vikshepa, which is otherwise called Bhranti. Bhranti means delusion. The nature of delusion, which is the third state of Jiva. What is that? Kutasthe Bhasamana Janmadi Samsaraha Vede Bhrantihi Iti Uchyate. The samsara in the form of Janma, Marana, etc., which is appearing in Kutastha, not there in Kutastha, but appearing in Kutastha, means appearing in the total Jiva, in which Kutastha also is included. So, person thinks what? I really have samsara, means what really I am, have samsara, and what really I am is what? Kutastha. And therefore it is said here, kutasthe vasavana janmadi samsara. So samsara, which appears to be there in kutastha, vede, in this samsara, Vede, in Vedas, means in Shastras, Bhranti Hiti Uchyate, is called Bhranti. And it is called Vikshepa also because it is the projection of this Avidya. Therefore, it is called Vikshepa also. And it is a Bhranti because really Samsara is not there, and Samsara is not there in Kutastha, but appears to be there in Kutastha. So, Sambandha with Kutastha also is Adhyastha. And the Swarupa of the Samsara also is Adhyastha. But here we are more highlighting in, here this Granthakara is highlighting the Sambandha. Kutasthe Bhasamana Samsaraha Bhrantihi. And afterwards he will, Swarupata Adhyastha Samsara also will be included. But in this paragraph, in this sentence, he is highlighting the Samsara which is appearing in Kutastha is Bhranti. Alright. And this samsara which is appearing in Kutastha is Bhranti. Why? It will be said afterwards. That because it is said to be negated by knowledge. And anything which is negated by knowledge is Mithya. But considered to be real, therefore it is Bhranti. Alright. अयमेव संसारः शोक शब्देन अपि उच्यते. दिस भ्रांति इज आल्सो कॉल्ड संसारा, इज कॉल्ड भ्रांति. अयमेव संसारः एंड दिस संसारा अलोन, बाय द वर्ड, बाय द एक्सप्रेशन अयमेव संसारः, व्हाट इज सेड? दिस संसारा व्हिच इज अपीयरिंग इन कूटस्थ, व्हिच इज कॉल्ड भ्रांति इन वेदास, दिस संसारा शोक शब्देन अपि उच्यते, इज आल्सो कॉल्ड शोकः, इज आल्सो कॉल्ड सॉरो. इट इज नॉट दैट द संसार कॉजेस सॉरो, संसार इज सॉरो. स्वामी प्रत्यक्षानंदी हैड टोल्ड सम इयर्स अगो दिस. ही सेड, समबडी सेड, स्वामी जी आई एम संसारी एंड आई एम वेरी दुखी. ही सेड, यू नीड नॉट से. When you say I am samsari, okay, he is understood. Bolne ki jarurat nahi. So when I say samsari, means samajh gaya, pura package hai uska. So I am eva samsara, शोक शब्द है ना अपयुक्त बट फॉर दैट पर्सन मस्ट हैव मेंट इज मैरिड संसारी में मैरिड एंड आई एम दुखी आई डिड नॉट से समझ में आ गया सो अयम एव संसार शोक शब्द है ना भी उच्यते इज आल्सो कॉल्ड रेफर टू बाय द वर्ड शोका सॉरो दिस संसार अलोन इज रेफर टू बाय द वर्ड शोका सॉरो एंड नाउ ही इज कोटिंग मेनी श्रुति टू शो दैट This samsara is said to be in Shastra as Jnana Nivartya, negatable or removable by knowledge. And that which is removable by knowledge has to be Mithya, Bhranti Rupaha. That idea is going to be conveyed. So he quotes many Shruti Vakya. Tatra ko moha kashokaha ekatva manupashyataha tarati shokamatmavit विद्यते हृदय ग्रंथिः चिद्यन्ते सर्व संशयाः क्षीयन्ते चास्य कर्माणि तस्मिन् दृष्टे परावरे मत्तः परतरं नान्यत् किञ्चिदस्ति धनंजय न कर्तृत्वं न कर्माणि लोकस्य सृजति प्रभुः अज्ञानेनावृतं ज्ञानं तेन मुह्यन्ति जन्तवः वासुदेवः सर्वमिति स महात्मासु दुर्लभः इत्यादि श्रुति स्मृतिभिः संसारस्य आत्मैकत्व ज्ञान मात्र निवर्त्यत्व बोधिकाभि भ्रम मात्रत्वं बोधितम् कस्य संसारस्य मेन सेंटेंस इज संसारस्य ऑफ दिस वर्ल्ड विच इज दुखात्मक भ्रम मात्रत्वं बोधितम् बोधितम् इज रिवील्ड संसार इज भ्रम मात्र इज ओनली This delusion, bodhitam, it is revealed. How? Bodhika bihi, shruti bihi. By the shruti and smruti, which are revealer. Revealer of what? Jnana matra nivartya. Samsara is removable only by knowledge. Knowledge of what? Ekatva, of oneness. So, ekatva jnana matra nivartyatva bodhikabhihi shruti smrutibhihi samsarasya brahma matratva bodhitam. So, by the shruti and smruti, this samsara is brahma matra, is only a delusion that is revealed. And what type of shruti and smruti? Shruti and smruti which are revealing the fact. What is the fact? That this samsara is removable by, negatable by the knowledge of oneness of Atma, Atmaikatva. So, Shruti which is revealing this fact that by knowledge of oneness of Atma, samsara goes away. What is suggested? That samsara is Brahma Matra, Brahma Matram. So here Anumana is suggested. Anumana if we can say or Arthapatti. How? What is Anumana? Samsaraha, Brahma Matram. संसारः भ्रम मात्रम् वाय एकत्व ज्ञान निवर्त्यत्वात् रज्जु सर्पादिवत् दिस संसार इज ओनली अ डेल्यूशन वाय बिकॉज इट इज रिमूवेबल बाय नॉलेज लाइक व्हाट रूप स्नेक यत्र यत्र ज्ञान निवर्त्यत्वम् तत्र तत्र भ्रम मात्रत्वम् So by that vyutpat, by that vyapti, yatha rajju sarpo, rajju sarpe. So that which is removable by knowledge has to be bhranti. Because dhanam cannot remove something which is real. Really existent thing cannot be removed by dhanam. and totally non-existent also cannot be removed by Jnana. Why? It is not there to be removed. So by Jnanam, if something is removed, it cannot be Sat, it cannot be Asat, it cannot be existent, nor it can be non-existent. Therefore, what should it be? Seemingly existent. And seemingly existent is what? Mithya Bhranti. Therefore, if something is removed by Jnanam, it has to be Bhranti Rupam. Alright. That idea is given. And what are those Shruti? Which are Ekatva, Ekatva Pratipadika, and revealing the fact that by Jnanam, Samsara is removed. The Shrutis are given. Tarati Tatrako Moha Kashokaha Ekatva Manu Pashyata. Isha Vasya Upadesha. Started with that Isha. Isha Kena Kata Prashna. So Isha start. So what is that? Tatra means Dhanavasthayam. Kaha Moha Kashokaha. Where Shoka is there? Where Moha is there? For a person who is seeing Ekatvam. Who is seeing oneness. So Moha and Shoka are representative of Samsara. So when Ekatvam, Ekatva Jnanam comes, there is no question of Moha and Shoka. Therefore, Samsaraha, Shoka Mohatmaka Samsaraha, Ekatva Jnana Nivartyaha, that is presented here. And Tarati Shokam Atmavit, the knower of the self crosses over the ocean of Samsara. And therefore, Shoka Nivurti is by Atmak Jnanam. What type of Atmajnanam? From other Shruti we understood Ekatva Advaita Atmajnanam. Otherwise Atmajnanam everybody has. Shoka should not come. Therefore Atmavit means what? Advaita Atmavit Shokam Tarati. So here also Shoka, which is representative of Samsara, is said to be removed by Atmaikatva Jnanam. Vidyate Hridaya Granthihi Chidyante Sarva Samshaya Kshiyante chasya karmani tasmin drishte paravare. This is also a very popular shloka. All knots of the heart are destroyed, all doubts are destroyed, and all karmas, punya papas, are also destroyed when paravare drishte, tasmin paravare drishte sati. When paravara, paravara has different meanings, paramapi avaram yasmat, or paramcha aparamcha paravare. So that which is appearing as the Karana and Karya, but free from Karya Karana, that Brahman, when it is seen as oneself, then Samsara in the form of Samshaya, Grathi, Karma goes away. Or Param means Hiranyagarbha. Hiranyagarbha also is inferior to which? Brahma. That is called Paravara. Means Adhishthana Brahma. When it is seen as Atma, then Samsara goes away. Mattah Parataram Nanyat Kinchid Asti Dhananjaya. So that Atma is that other than which nothing is there. Mattah Parataram Anyat. Anything other than me which is superior to me is not there. Anything which is here, parataram has got a meaning karanam. Any karanam is not there. I alone am there. So it is suggesting of Atmai Tattva. And na kartrutvam na karmani lokasya srijati prabhu. Ishvara does not create kartrutvam and karma of the world. Means Atma is free from this kartrutvam and karmani. But it appears to be there. And therefore it is mithya. Agnanena avrutam jnanam tena muhyanti jantavaha. Since the knowledge is as though covered by agnanam, and therefore people are deluded. By this what is suggested? Only because of agnanam samsara is there. And Vasudeva sarvamiti sa mahatmasu durlabaha. So Vasudeva is everything. Samahat. In this manner, one who knows that Mahatma is Durlabha. So by this, what is understood? That Vasudeva Sarvam. That is the main. Vasudeva is Sarvam. Sarvam is Vasudeva. Badha Samanadikaranyam. therefore the samsara nasti sarvam nasti vasudeva evasti and then ekatva gnanam is there by this ekatva gnanam alone there is samsara nivritti by this all shruti and smriti which says that by ekatva gnanam of atma samsara goes away what is suggested that is samsara is bhranti rupah this is a very important point in vedanta that samsara problem goes away by knowledge itself shows that this samsara is adhyastah atha to brahma jignasa we derive that for mumukshu atha shows that person is a mumukshu for mumukshu brahma jignasa brahma vichara is suggested brahma vichara is for what for jnanam so for mumukshu jnanam is suggested as the means the bondage which this mumukshu wants to be free from should be removed by knowledge then only vedavyasa will prescribe bhagwan vedavyasa says for a mumukshu jnanam should be attained so jnanam is prescribed as the medicine for the samsara therefore jnanam removes samsara and samsara can be removed only by samsara can be removed by jnanam only when it is adhyastha therefore as an introduction to athato brahma jignasa adhyasa bhashya people say what of why bhashyakara athato brahma jignasa simple meaning thereafter therefore there should be desire for knowing brahman usme adhyastha koi dikhta hi nahi was hai andar isme is there okay. So bhranti swarupa is presented what is bhranti that I am samsari samsara is bhranti and I am samsari is bhranti samsara is swarupatah adhyastha and samsara mai sambandhena adhyastha so adhyasa samsarga adhyasa is there swarupa adhyasa all right the tippani has come vikshepa shoka brahma matra okay yes yeah because the tippani sometimes refa and visarga and all this with mixed up see it goes immediately after there is refa okay so brahma matratvam bodhitam kasya samsarasya samsara is brahma alone in this manner it was said so tippani kara said that this explanation did not cover the idea of the vikshepa so vikshepa word did not come therefore he is explaining that dehendriya prana mano ahankara adinam janmadi tadvikaranam cha atmani pratyakchaitanye bhanam atmanah tadharmanam satyagdananta satyagdananta nandadinam वा अनात्मने भानं च अध्यासः इति उच्यते अस्य एव भ्रान्तिः विक्षेपः शोकः इत्यादि व्यपदेशाः सो दिस भ्रान्ति इज अदरवाइज कॉल्ड अध्यास एंड व्हाट इज दैट अध्यास इज देह इंद्रिय प्राण मनोहंकारादीनां जन्मादि तद्विकाराणां च आत्मनि प्रत्यक्ष चैतन्य भानम् cognition experience of deha body indriya organs prana vital air manaha mind ahankara ego adipadena buddhi something we have to take chitta so dehendriya prana mano mahankara adinam pratyak chaitanye bhanam the experience of dehadi in atma which is inner consciousness dhanam is adhyasa and so here it is called dharmi adhyasa technically it is called dharmi adhyasa so experience of the dehadi in atma means as atma and janmadi तद्विकाराणां च सॉरी इन इन आत्मादि अध्यास ऑफ देम मींस प्रत्येक आत्मा इज सीन एज देहादि, सो देहादि एटसेट्रा देर एक्सपीरियंस इन आत्मा मीन्स आत्मा इज एक्सपीरियंस एज दैट एंड जन्मादि तद विकाराणां च एंड ऑल्सो दी मॉडिफिकेशंस ऑफ तद रेफर्स टू देहेन्द्रिय मनो प्राण मनो अहंकारादि the product or the modification, not product, modification such as janma etc. and whose modification? Dehadi. Tesham bhanam. The experience of the body etc. in atma and experience of the modifications such as birth etc. in atma is adhyasa. Atasmin tad buddhi, that is called adhyasa. So dehendriyadi, they are not there in atma, but atma appears to be like that dehadi, and the modifications of dehadi are not there in atma, but appears to be in atma. So that is called adhyasa. Means what? Seeing the body etc. and their modification in Atma is Adhyasa. Means seeing Atma as Dehadi and seeing Atma to be endowed with the Janmadi Vikara is Adhyasa. This is called Anatmanam Atmani Adhyasa. Anatma Adhyasa. Now second is what? आत्मनः अनात्म्यनि अध्यासः आत्मनः तद्धर्माणां च सत्यज्ञानानन्तानन्दादीनां वा अनात्मनि भानम् एक्सपीरियंस ऑफ आत्मा एंड इट्स स्वरूप स्वरूप भूत धर्म इन अनात्मा इज कॉल्ड आत्माध्यासः सो द सुपर इम्पो द एक्सपीरियंस ऑफ आत्मा and its dharma. Here dharma is a figurative expression. Qualities. Here qualities, what are the qualities? Satya, Jnana, Ananta, Ananda. These qualities of Atma, qualities in the sense of Swarupa here. The qualities or Swarupa of Atma on Anatma is called Adhyasa. So the experience of Atma and Atma Dharma on Anatma is called Adhyasa. And that will be called what? Atma Adhyasa. And Atma Adhyasa is two types. Dharmi Adhyasa, Dharma Adhyasa. How it will be experienced? When I say that this body is, when we say body is, that existence does not belong to body. But we superimpose the existence of the Atma on the body. That will be called Atma Adhyasa. When I say I am fat, then it is the adhyasa of anatma on atma. So this is how this adhyasa is there. So superimposition of anatma and anatma dharma on atma and superimposition of atma and atma dharma on anatma, both of them are called adhyasa. And this atma adhyasa, anatma adhyasa, dharmi adhyasa, dharma adhyasa, all of them, asya eva, of this adhyasa alone, brantihi, delusion, vikshepaha, projection, shokaha, grief, ityadi vyapadeshaha, such names are there. Vyapadesha means names. So all these are the names of adhyasa only. Alright. So far how many stages we have covered? Three stages. Abdhanam and avaranam and brantihi. Very, not very pleasant state, it's shoka only. So now we go to the solution part. Solution is what? Jnanam. In this jnanam also two stages are there. Parokshak jnanam, aparokshak jnanam. That is being talked about in the next paragraph. Paroksha parokshak jnana swarupam. The nature of parokshak jnanam, the indirect knowledge of Brahma, and aparokshak jnanam, this direct knowledge of Brahma. And in simple words, ब्रह्म अस्ति इति ज्ञानम इज परोक्ष ज्ञानम, ब्रह्म अस्मि इति ज्ञानम इज अपरोक्ष ज्ञानम। दैट इज सेड हियर, ब्रह्म नास्ति इति असत्वापादकावरणांशम अस्ति ब्रह्म इति वेदांत वाक्यजन्य परोक्ष ज्ञानम नाशयति। अस्ति ब्रह्म, ब्रह्मन एग्जिस्ट इति इन दिस मैनर वेदांत वाक्य जन्य परोक्ष ज्ञान, इनडायरेक्ट नॉलेज बॉर्न ऑफ द वेदांत वाक्य। व्हाट टाइप ऑफ वाक्य? ब्रह्मन इज सत्यम दानम अनंतम ब्रह्म, ब्रह्मन इज कारणम एटसेट्रा। दिस वेदांत वाक्यास आर गिविंग राइज टू द नॉलेज दैट अस्ति ब्रह्म। दैट नॉलेज नाशयति, डिस्ट्रॉयज। व्हाट डज इट डिस्ट्रॉय? असत्वापादक आवरण अंश, the part of the avarana, the veiling, concealment, which is apadaka, which is the cause for asatva, the transaction of non-existence, which is expressed as what? Brahma nasti, Brahman is not there. So the cause for Brahma nasti vyavahara, the Brahman is not there, is called asatva padaka avaranam. And that asatva padaka avaranamsha is removed by the knowledge what? Asti Brahma, Brahman is there. So asti Brahma jnanam removes the asatva padaka avarana of avarana shakti. In simple words, when I understood that Brahman exists, then my idea, my vyavahara, that Brahma nasti is not there. It means that one avaranam on Brahman goes away. Alright. Then, what type of paroksha jnanam of Brahman will be? Brahma satya jnana ananta swarupam bhavati iti jnanam paroksha jnanam iti uchyati. Brahman is satya, unnegatable jnanam, consciousness, ananta swarupam, it is of infinite nature. Iti jnanam. When you have this type of knowledge, Brahman is like this, Brahman is like this, Brahman is satya, Brahman is ananta, Brahman is jnanam, that type of knowledge is paroksha jnanam iti uchyate. He is called paroksha jnanam, indirect knowledge. Alright. And this paroksha, idam cha paroksha jnanam nasti brahma iti pratiti virodhi. And this indirect knowledge is the antidote or opposite to the experience. What was the experience? Nasti Brahma. Brahman does not exist. So this paroksha jnanam is antidote or opposite to the experience which was there, that Brahman is not there. Natu anyasya kasya chidapi virodhi. This paroksha jnanam is not contradictory or not opposite to anything else. And here anything else means Brahma na bhati iti yasya pratitehe virodhi na. Brahman is there, but he is not seen. Bole Swami ji yahan hai, dikhte nahi hai. The chappal is there outside, must be there. It's not seen. So there itself has given me some relief. At hand, I thought Swami ji may be there, may not be there. Brahman is there, and somebody told also, Swami ji is there. He is not there. He is sitting in the garden somewhere. Seeing who is coming. Okay. So, Brahman asti, that knowledge will remove only Brahma nasti vyavahara pratiti. All we'll see in the next class. Om Purnamada Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnamevavashishyate. Shanti 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 Hari Om Shri Guru Namo.